How can we encourage the Muslim world considering our current political situation? And also he asked about which one will come first, Ad-Dajjal or the Khilafat? Obviously, every day passes by, we are moving forward, approaching the end of life, the Day of Judgment. On an individual level or on a communal level, each person lives in this life for a certain period of time. Each day passes by and zips off is deducting from his balance. He's running in short, in minus. Similarly, the whole life, the Prophet ﷺ said, بُعِثْتُ أَنَا وَالسَّاعَةِ كَهَاتَيْنِ. He pointed with the index and the middle finger and said, my prophethood, being appointed as a prophet, my ba'tha, and the Day of Judgment are that close. Even if it is 1,000 or 2,000 years, with regards to the lifespan in general, it's nothing. So there are minor and major signs that precede the occurrence of the Day of Judgment. Among the major signs, the Prophet ﷺ spoke about the second coming of Jesus, the Son of Mary, the emergence of Al-Mahdi, the rightly guided person who would lead the Ummah towards success, and he would lead them in several wars against the Romans, against the Persians, against the Jews, and obviously against the Dajjal in Jerusalem, and finally he will defeat them all. And also spoke about the emergence of the false Messiah, and he said there is not a single prophet, but he warned his people against this trial. That is the worst trial that people may be exposed to. So if we examine all the ahadith and the prophecies pertaining Al-Mahdi, who is one of the descendants of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his family, and the false Messiah, we recognize the following: that Al-Mahdi will come out, he will be a living human being, an ordinary person. His name and his father's name would match the Prophet's name and the Prophet's father's name. There will be before Al-Mahdi a state of Khilafah. So the Khilafah will be established before the coming or the emergence of Al-Mahdi. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. But the whole Ummah would go through a state of weakness. As a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fix Al-Mahdi and make him an upright person overnight. Al-Mahdi minna alal bayt yuslihuhu Allahu fi layla. Overnight, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him an upright person who would gather the ummah around him in order to lead them to victory after victory, then finally defeating the false Messiah and his allies from Asbahan and everywhere else. In the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in a hadith narrated by Thawban, may Allah be pleased with him, and it's a sound hadith collected by Sahih al-Imam Muslim, the Imam Muslim in his Sahih collection, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ زَوَى لِيَ الْأَرْضَ مَشَارِقَهَا وَمَغَارِبَهَا وَإِنَّ أُمَّتِي سَيَبْلُغُ مُلْكُهَا مَا زُوِيَ لِي مِنْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have gathered the whole earth, the east and the west, to me. It's like you're seeing a model before your very eyes. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, I could see my domain, my deen, my religion, and my followers are going to dominate all over the earth. مَشَارِقَهَا وَمَغَارِبَهَا, the east and the west. There will not be a single place, but it would enter Islam. As in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, لَا يَبْقَى عَلَى ظَهْرِ الْأَرْضِ بَيْتُ مَدَرٍ وَلَا وَبَرٍ إِلَّا أَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِعِزِّ عَزِيزٍ أَوْ بِذُلِّ ذَلِيلٍ عِزًّا يُعِزُّ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْإِسْلَامَ وَأَهْلَهُ وَذُلًّا يُذِلُّ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْكُفْرَ وَأَهْلَهُ. This hadith says that there would not be a single house be made of bricks, rocks and stones, or of wood, or of mud, even villages and huts. Every house shall experience Islam. Islam is going to spread all over, whether people like it or not. عزًا يعز الله به الإسلام وأهله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give this deen mighty and dignity, that those who will become believers will be given this mighty and will be honored due to accepting Islam. And the opposite will happen to the disbelievers. All of that will happen as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted the second Khilafah to come one day. Then when it gets weak, Al-Mahdi will emerge and would lead the Ummah to success. Then Isa, the son of Mary, will descend, peace be upon him, and he will follow the Mahdi and will refuse to lead Muslims in the prayer. Not to think that he is coming with the second message. Rather, he's coming to assure the Ummah and confirm that he is a Muslim and he's a follower of the same deen that all the prophets came with. Al-Anbiya'u ikhwatul li'allat. Deenuhum wahid wa ummahatuhum shatta. So the second coming of Isa alayhi salam does not mean that he has a different message or he will be the last messenger. The last was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. They will both join hands and would lead the ummah towards victory, which will end with the defeat of the false messiah and his disappearance and so on. From all of that, we understand that the Khilafah would actually be accomplished before the false messiah and his emergence. Thank you so much. And I just want you to imagine that we are living in a very special time where the unexpected have already happened. Many of the tyrant rulers in the Muslim world are now either being thrown in prison, being tried by their own people, or fugitives in other countries, or being killed by their own people. So a year ago, people could never imagine that one day will take place. These rulers thought that they are gods. They've got all the power in the world. They can give life and death. So as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defeated them. So the change does not necessarily have to happen over a century or two or even decades. It can happen, as we see, overnight, in a few weeks, in a few months, and the rest to come, inshaAllah azza jal. But we just need to remember one thing. In order to gain this victory, we as Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, may Allah make us amongst them, we do not call Al-Mahdi alayhi salam, we do not call him Al-Mahdi al-Muntadhar. The word Muntadhar is added by the Shia sect because life freezes until Al-Mahdi returns or emerges according to their belief. While for the mainstream of the Ummah, every person is required to work hard to do their utmost in order to prove themselves in this life. Obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fulfilling their duties towards Allah and towards their communities, towards themselves. Then, if they pass away, if they die before they witness the emergence of Al-Mahdi, that is perfectly fine. So we do not call him the awaiting Mahdi. We're not just living waiting for the coming of Al-Mahdi, peace be upon him, or Jesus, the son of Mary. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ رَهِينَةً. Every person will be held accountable for what they did. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اِعْمَلُوا فَكُلُّ مُيَسَّرٌ لِمَا خُلِقَ لَهُ. So the proactive Muslims are not waiting, sitting back and just waiting for a savior to come in order to achieve success on their behalf. No, at all. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْرِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَّ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَّكُمْ. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking from us with regards to confronting our enemies on the battlefield, He does not necessarily ask us to possess nuclear weapons. If it is not possible, if it is not in our hands, He says, you just need to prepare as much as you can afford. Because as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, upon the defeat that took place on the battle of Uhud, He said, Allahu maulana wa la maula lahum. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our ally, He is our supporter, He is the one who gives victory or defeat others. Imagine if Allah is on your side and He's only asking you to exert as much effort as possible. Nothing beyond the impossible. Beyond the possible, I mean. Nothing too much. Just what you can afford. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver. وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَيَسْتَخْلِفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كَمَا اسْتَخْلَفَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا. This success and establishment for the Muslim Ummah and the Khilafah, etc. on earth. Number one, to believe properly by the heart and to verify this belief by one's actions. Number two, عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, doing the good righteous deeds. Not a single time in the Quran Allah promises the believers with heaven, but you would always find الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Doing the good righteous deeds must be attached and inseparable from the matter of belief. إِمَانٌ وَعَمَلْ. As Imam Abu Hanifa رحمه تعالى used to say, الإيمان ما وقر في القلب وصدقه العمل. It settles in the heart. Faith is what settles firmly in the heart and is been verified by one's actions, not by mere claims. Then يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا. That is the third and the fourth condition. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be devout worshipper, not only in the physical worship, in the prayers or fasting, but our entire life should revolve around obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because al-ibadah is doing what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether of actions or sayings, the actions of the heart and the limbs, or the sayings of the heart or the tongue, without setting partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship.